Good morning, dear cadets. So as you know, your unit number 13 is completely completed. Even single thing I have not left. Now this is the time to solve the NCERT exercises. Okay? So page number 400, exercise number 13.2. 13.1 exercise belongs to the IUPAC name, and I hope that you can do this one. Okay? I am starting with exercise number 13.2. What is the question? Question is, give one chemical test to distinguish between the following pairs of compound. Okay? So while dealing with the unit, already I have hinted you that which particular test is used to distinguish the pairs. And in pre-board test, you might have seen that such type of questions are being asked. And almost all the set, 2 to 4 marks question you will get from this particular types. Okay, so it is better to prepare. Okay, so now means whatever distinguishing pairs are there here, they will belongs to the amines chapter only. So the first pair is methyl amine and dimethyl amine. Okay, so methyl, first what we should do? First we should write their formula. Once you write the formula, then you will get the hint. So just see, methylamine means CH3NH2 and dimethylamine means CH3NHCH3. So this is 2 degree amines and this is 1 degree amines. This is 2 degree aliphatic amines, this is 1 degree aliphatic amines. Okay, so on what basis we can distinguish? Just see, carbyl amine reaction is given by aliphatic and aromatic primary amines. But secondary amines, let it be aliphatic or aromatic, they do not give this test. So which test we have to apply? We have to apply the carbyl amine reaction. So just write down here, first what you will write? By, here write by carbyl amine reaction. Carbyl amine reaction. Okay, now carbyl amine reaction, that is the heading, means we can distinguish with the help of carbyl amine reaction. Okay, mere writing that one is not enough, you have to write the reaction also. Even though in NCERT book they have given the reaction of ethyl amine with chloroform and KOH. But methyl amine reaction also I taught, because I was aware that this question is there. So same again I am telling here, just see what would be there. CH3NH2 plus chloroform plus 4KOH. Okay, now here what would be the product? Here product would be CH3N double bond coordinate bond C plus 3KCl plus 3H2O. Okay, what would be there? 4, 5, 3, 2, 6. Yes, let me see the reaction. Is it balanced or not? Total how many OH is there here? 6 and 9. Here 4, here 5. And 3, 2, 5. Yes, 4, 5. Yes, balance. You can check here. Yes, everything is balanced. Total number, nitrogen. Yes, no problem at all. So this is, you have to write here product name also. Methyl isocyanide. Methyl isocyanide. Okay, that is there. Foul smelling compound will form. And as far as dimethylamine is concerned, write down here formula, CH3 whole twice NH, here write CHCl3, here write KOH, or directly you write aero marks, aero, just see, here write chloroform CHCl3 plus KOH, and here write no reaction. Now distinction is over, means dimethylamine will not give this reaction, but this one will give. Okay, over. Now you will get the full marks. The purpose of teaching the NCERT exercise is to make you aware that how to write the answers. These answers are available, okay, everywhere. In the net also they are available. In the different kinds of books they are available. But I have to tell how to solve. Next question is secondary and tertiary amine, okay. So secondary, primary, secondary and tertiary amine react with nitrous acid in different ways. In NCERT book, they have given the reaction of primary amines only with nitrous acid. They have not given the reaction with secondary amines and tertiary amines. Nevertheless, in my video, I have explained you. And see, here, that is the problem with the NCERT book. Questions are there, but their explanations are not there. So that reaction I taught you, again I will tell. Secondary and tertiary amine. So here just see why they have written their name. Okay, name only. They have not written the formula. They have written here name. Why they have written the name? So that you should confuse. They don't want to give you number. But if you have caliber, you just snatch the number from their hands. Okay, so just see secondary amines. Write down one secondary amines. CH3CH2 fold twice NH. This is secondary amine. Tertiary amine CH3CH2 whole thrice N. Okay, means the same question can be asked like that also. How you will distinguish between diethyl amine and triethyl amine? Okay, so the meaning is same only, secondary amine and tertiary amine. Means same thing can be asked. Okay, in chemistry question can be cooked. You know this one. Okay, so now here second one, just see, take one particular example. Both react in different ways. Just see, CH3CH2 whole twice NH plus HONO. Okay, this is nitrous acid. So now here what would be there? Just remove one molecules of water. One molecules of water, what would be the product? CH3CH2 whole twice, what is there? N double bond O, correct? N double bond O, okay? There is no need to write anything else, okay? Now what would be there? What would be the name of this one? Now just see here. One more N should be there here. N, single bond N. Okay. And now just see. With this N, what is the name of this one? Nitroso. This nitroso group is bonded with N. So N, nitroso, N, nitroso, diethyl amine. Or N, nitrosa mean also you can write. N, nitroso dimethyl amine, no problem. N nitroso diethyl amine, diethyl amine. What color of PPT it will give? It will give yellow PPT. Yes, yellow color. Plus here H2O, H2O, yellow. Okay, this test is known as Liebermann nitroso test. What is the name of this one? Liebermann nitroso test. Okay, when this compound is treated with phenol, so it gives purple color. That you should not write, that much is enough. When it is treated with, if it is treated with phenol and crystal of phenol and concentrate H2SO4, so it gives green color. What does it give? Green color. Okay, and when it is treated with base NaOH, so it produces deep blue color, and upon dilution red color. Okay, this is the complete Liebermann nitroso test. What is there? First you should react one means secondary amine with nitrous acid. Then this will form, their PPT will be yellow color. When this compound is treated with crystal of phenol and concentrate H2SO4, so it produces green color. When it is treated with, means it should be alkaline, this solution should be alkaline with NaOH. So it will produce deep blue color, and upon dilution it will produce red color. This is complete Liebermann nitroso test. And what about trimethylamine or triethylamine? CH3CH2 whole thrice N. Here you write no Liebermann test. Liebermann nitroso test. Just see, you can't write that it does not react with nitrous acid. It reacts with nitrous acid, and it will give this one of the compound, but along with this one alcohol is there. If you want to write, this reaction would be like that. Just see, CH3CH2 whole thrice N. I taught this reaction, their reaction with HONO. Okay, so now entire molecules will be bonded here, because replaceable hydrogen is not there with the tertiary amine. So what would be the product here? CH3CH2 whole thrice N dot HONO. When you heat this one, then what would be there? CH2 whole twice N single bond N double bond O. This would be there, and plus 1 CH3CH2OH. Okay, this would be the reaction. First, entire molecules of this one will be added here. Just see, HONO is added. When you heat this one, then what would be there? NNO, and this HO, and one ethyl group will come out from here, and it will form alcohol. So in secondary amine, alcohol is not produced. Here one of the product is alcohol, and now this product and this product is same only. Okay, so that is the distinction between 3 degree and 2 degree amines and their reaction with HONO. Okay, so this reaction should be written. Okay, now third question is ethyl amine and aniline. I'm now just see what I told you, carbyl amine reaction is given by 1 degree aliphatic amines and 1 degree aromatic amines. This is given by both. Okay, 1 degree aliphatic amine also give the carbyl amine reaction, and 1 degree aromatic amine also give the Liebermann test, carbyl amine reaction. I'm now just see, ethyl amine means CH3CH2NH2. This is aliphatic 1 degree amine, and this one C6H5NH2. This is aromatic 1 degree amine. Okay, both, this is 1 degree aromatic, and this is 1 degree aliphatic. Okay, so just see, both are giving the carbyl amine reaction, so we can't distinguish with the help of carbyl amine reaction. Then what is there? Another test should be there, and that test is not given in NCERT book. Okay, what is there? Aliphatic 1 degree amine and aromatic 1 degree amine both gives carbyl amine reaction. So with the help of carbyl amine reaction, we can't distinguish. Then another test should be there, which can be used to distinguish between 1 degree aliphatic amines and 1 degree aromatic amines. Okay, what is the name of that test? Azo dye test. Okay, remember, azo dye test is used to distinguish between 1 degree aliphatic amine and 1 degree aromatic amines. Okay, remember that azo dye test is very easy test. Okay, first just see, azo dye test is given by the aromatic 1 degree amines, but aliphatic 1 degree amines will not give that test. Okay, so I have to teach that one. Okay, just see the third number. What is the third number? Ethyl amine and aniline. So ethyl amine is aliphatic 1 degree, aniline is aromatic 1 degree amine. So just see, they can be distinguished by azo dye test. This is also known as beta naphthol test. This is just equivalent to coupling reaction. Okay, but remember, coupling reaction I taught with respect to benzene diazonium chloride. Okay, here what is there? Aromatic primary amines give this test, but aliphatic primary amines means CH3CH2NH2, okay, does not give this test. Okay, just see, first what should be there? Aniline should be converted into benzene diazonium chloride. What is the name of process? Diazotization. Okay, diazotization. So now you have got the benzene diazonium chloride. Now this benzene diazonium chloride should react with beta naphthol or 2 naphthol. That is why this test is known as beta naphthol. Just see, in coupling reaction what you did, you made the reaction between benzene diazonium chloride either with aniline or with phenol. Here what is there? First you have to convert the same thing. There is no difference. Aniline first should be converted into benzene diazonium chloride. Now benzene diazonium chloride should react with beta naphthol. This is the formula of beta naphthol. Two benzene rings should be there. And now in first benzene ring, upper side benzene ring, at this position only OS should be there. Their numbering is different. Here two benzene ring is fused. Two benzene ring is fused. And this would be 1, 2. So at 2 position OH is there. That is why this is known as 2 naphthol. Okay. And in Greek system of nomenclature, this is alpha carbonatom. This is beta carbonatom. That is why this is known as, at beta carbonatom OH group is there. That is why it is beta naphthol. In presence of dilute NaOH. So from the alpha carbon atom, 1 H and this HCl should come out. Plus here write HCl. And rest everything just you add. This benzene ring, now this is extended conjugated system only, just like a coupling reaction. Two benzene ring, basically three benzene ring is held together by diazo group. So with 1N, what is there? Phenyl group is there. This is 1 phenyl, then azo, 2 naphthol, 1 phenyl azo for N double bond N. 1 phenyl azo 2 naphthol. This is orange red dye. What is this one? Orange red dye plus HCl. Okay. So aniline will give this test. Now just see this one. Aliphatic primary amines, that is C2H5NH2. This will not give azo dye test. This will not give azo dye test. So this should be distinguished with the help of azo dye test. Since color compound is formed, that is why this is known as azo dye test. Okay, please remember, this is the most important. And nowhere azo dye test word is mentioned in case of NCERT book. Okay, so now third one is over. What about fourth one? Just see, aniline and benzyl amine. Just see this one. Aniline means C6H5NH2. Okay, now this is aromatic primary amine. This will give the carbyl amine reaction. Carbyl amine reaction. And what about benzyl amine? C6H5CH2NH2. This is aryl alkyl amine. This will no carbyl amine reaction. No carbyl amine reaction. So with the help of carbyl amine reaction, we can distinguish, because carbyl amine reaction is given by 1 degree aliphatic and 1 degree aromatic primary amines. And this is not a aliphatic primary amine. This is aryl alkyl primary amines. Okay. So this will not give, this will give, and you should write the reaction, and you know reaction I have already taught. Okay. Last one is aniline and N-methyl aniline. Just see. What is the formula of aniline? Just see. C6H5NH2. N-methyl aniline means C6H5NH. 1H replaced from NH2 group and add here CH3. Okay. So this will not give carbyl amine reaction, because this is 2 degree aromatic amines. This is 2 degree aromatic amine. This only will give the carbyl amine reaction. Carbyl amine reaction, this will give, but this will no carbyl amine reaction. Okay, no carbyl amine reaction. So it will not give carbyl amine reaction, this will give carbyl amine reaction. Write the reaction also. Mere writing name is not enough. You have to write the complete reaction with aniline. And already I taught you aniline, how you will write C6H5NH2. Here what is there? Chloroform, CsCl3 plus 4KOH. What is the product here? C6H5 and double bond coordinate bond C plus 3KCl plus 3H2O. Over. This is phenyl isocyanide. That is foul smelling compound. Please remember, below the product, IUPAC name or common name must be there. If they specified IUPAC name, then you have to write the IUPAC name. Otherwise, any name can be. But it must be there. And with the property of that compound, this compound is foul smelling compound, you have to write the foul smelling compound. Over. In this way, this question is completely completed. Let us move to the another set of questions. Okay, so just see. Now, exercise number 13.3. Account for the following. In account for the following means, you have to give reasons. Okay, reasons you have to explain. Okay, so just see. PKB of aniline is more than that of methylamine. So, greater the PKB value, what you will write here? Greater the PKB value, weaker will be the base. Okay, and now just see, means aniline will be weaker base. And now just see, mere writing that one is not enough. Now you have to explain how, why aniline is a weaker base. Just see, this is NH2, aniline is there, all resonating structure you have to make. Okay, and what you will write? Since the lone pair electron of aniline is conjugated means merge with, join with the 6 pi electron of benzene ring, hence they are not available for donation during the course of reaction, or when they are not available for donation when acid attack on them. Okay, just see why all resonating structure you make. So this electron, lone pair electron, will come to the ring or not? What is the name of this process? Conjugation means merging of lone pair of electron with the 6 pi delocalized electron of ring. You can say resonance also. In resonance, what is happening? In resonance, what is there? That is, resonance is the process of conjugation of lone pair electron of group with the 6 pi delocalized electron. Okay, so I hope that, and you can explain this one. In methylamine, what is there? CH3NH2. Now this lone pair of electron, resonance is not there here. No conjugation of lone pair electron with the alkyl group. So they are easily available for donation. That is why PKB, greater the PKB value, weaker will be the base. Aniline is a weaker base because their lone pair electron is conjugated with rings 6 pi delocalized electron due to resonance. Okay, all resonating structure you have to make. That is why aniline lone pair electron does not available for donation. In case of methylamine, what is there? Resonance is not there. So their lone pair electron is easily available for donation. Okay, so that you can write here. That is why PKB value of aniline is greater. Next question. Ethyl amine is soluble in water, whereas aniline is not. In aniline, what is there? What is the formula? This is the formula of aniline. Aniline is water insoluble due to water insoluble. Just see, water insoluble due to hydrophobic nature of aromatic ring okay? Already I have explained this one. While in ethylamine, what is there? Ethylamine, what is there? See, and now you can make, this will make hydrogen bond with the water. This is C, CH3CH2N. Here what is there? H. Here H. Here lone pair of means hydrogen bond with the water. O, here H, here H. Correct or not? So now this with the help of nitrogen it is making hydrogen bond. With the help of hydrogen also they will make the hydrogen bond, because ethyl amine will form hydrogen bond with the water, while aniline cannot form hydrogen bond with the water due to hydrophobic nature of aromatic ring. Hydrophobic nature of aromatic ring. Okay, you can explain easily. Now this side again you can form, just see, N, here what is there? H, here H, here what is there? CH2, here CH3, this is positive, this is negative, correct? Is there any problem here? Yes. Now this side also again you can make hydrogen bond with the water, that I have already explained. So simple word, aniline, hydrophobic nature of aromatic ring. This one, this form hydrogen bond with the water. And why it form hydrogen bond with the water? Because NH bond is polar. NH bond is polar. Okay. That is why it form hydrogen bond with the water. You know this one. Okay. Methylamine in water react with ferric chloride to precipitate ferric oxide. Yes, this question is a bit difficult, but don't worry, you can do. Methylamine in water react with ferric chloride. First, methylamine in water. So first write here CH3NH2 plus H2O. Okay. And now just see. Here lone pair of electron is there. Lone pair electron. That is why it is basic. And if it is basic, so somebody should be acidic, which can furnish nascent, means which can furnish the hydrogen H positive to this one. Okay. Always remember, in amines are basic in nature. When they react with the water, so they behave like a base. So water has to behave like a acid. Just see, water is the amphoteric compound. Their behavior depends upon who is reacting with the water. When alcohol is reacting with the water, then water will become acidic and alcohol will become basic. But when it is reacting with the amines, so this will be proton furnisher, means this would be acidic and amines will be the basic. Correct or not? Remember, means what does it indicate? It indicates that water is poor base than amines. Here methyl amines we have taken. Okay, just see, this is basic, so it will furnish one proton to this one. So what would be the reaction? Here CH3, here NH3 positive sign, OH negative. You know that whenever water is reacting with any amines, then anilinium ion is formed. This is methyl ammonium hydroxide. Methyl ammonium hydroxide. Anilinium word is used in case of aniline. Here what is there? Ammonium. Methyl ammonium hydroxide. And now just see. Now this will furnish OH negative. Just write down here CH3NH3 positive plus OH negative. That is why, since they are furnishing OH negative ion, that is why they are basic in nature. Now just see, this is step number first. Now in step number two, it is reacting with ferric chloride. Ferric chloride means Fe3 positive, FeCl3. So now this will dissociate into Fe3 positive plus 3Cl negative. Now this Fe3 positive will react with OH negative. Just see, third step reaction, Fe3 positive plus 3OH negative. So here what would be there? FeOH whole thrice, and this is weak base. What is this one? Weak base. This is unstable compound. So this will dissociate into Fe2O3 dot XH2O. Now Fe, this is brown PPT. What is this one? Brown PPT. That is your question, na? Your question is methyl amine in water react with ferric chloride to precipitate ferric oxide. So this is ferric oxide only. It is precipitated out. Actually, this is for ferric hydroxide is for. It is forming brown PPT. Okay. Since it is unstable compound, so this will dissociate into Fe2O3 hex H2O. R3H2O also hydrated ferric oxide. Okay. Write down here 3H2O. 3H2O. This is hydrated ferric oxide. This means FeOH whole thrice can be written like that also. Okay. Or instead of writing this one, just you write R. OR. Yes. Means this can be written like that. Over. This is also over. That is why methylamine is. It means aqueous solution of methylamine react with ferric chloride and form this one, ferric oxide. Okay. Next one. This question I have explained. Although amino group is ortho para directing in aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction, aniline on nitration gives a substantial amount of meta nitro aniline. I have already explained this one. Actually, nitration is always carried out in strong acidic condition. Why strong acidic condition? Because you, for the nitration, you have to take concentrate H2SO4 and concentrate HNO3. Okay? And concentrate H2SO4 and concentrate HNO3, they are strong acids. So, strong acidic medium would be there. The meaning of strong acidic medium means there would be presence of H positive ion. So, when you subject aniline for nitration, then what would be there? NH2. Okay? I have already explained. Once again, I am telling you. Due to strong acidic condition, just see. H positive, write down here. Strong acidic condition. So, here what would be there? This. Here what would be? NH3, here positive. Now see, NH2 group is ortho para directing. This NH3 group is, what is the name of this one? Anilinium ion. This anilinium ion is number one, meta directing. That is why when you subject it for nitration, means when aniline is subjected for nitration, so aniline would also be there and some amount of anilinium ion will also be formed due to strong acidic condition. And this strong acidic condition will make NH2O to be converted into NH3, and NH3 positive ion is meta directing. So meta directing means NO2, when you are subjecting it for nitration, then NO2 group will be bonded with meta position. Okay, that is why along with the ortho para, substantial amount of meta nitro aniline will also be formed. One more property of this anilinium ion has got, this is deactivating group. What is the meaning of deactivating? It will withdraw the ring electron towards itself. So it renders benzene ring passive towards the electrophilic substitution reaction. Please remember, what is the meaning of this one? Deactivating group. What is the meaning of deactivating group? Renders ring passive towards, here I am writing, towards electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay, remember this one. So this is two property. NH3 is meta directing, and second one, it is strong deactivating group. It renders the ring passive towards the electrophilic substitution reaction because it withdraw the electron towards itself. NH2 group push the electron towards the benzene ring. means there would be a conjugation between lone pair of electron and 6 pi delocalized electron. But once the NH3 is formed, NH3 will do the reverse process. It will withdraw the electron towards itself from ortho and para position. Means reverse order resonating structure would be formed. And in the formation of when I told you aniline does not react with the, does not give the Friedel-Crafts reactions, in the video I have explained you resonating structure also. Okay, so this is also over. Aniline does not undergo Friedel-Crafts reaction. So their answer I told you that, just see, this is benzene ring, this is NH2, okay, lone pair of electron, this is AlCl3, they are electron deficient compound, Lewis acid, okay. So what they will do, they will form here, just see, this is ring, okay, alternate single and double bond, here what would be there, NH2 positive, and here dot, here write AlCl3 negative. Actually what would be there, they will form, see here lone pair, write down like that, see H2, write like that, one H here, one H here, and this lone pair of electron will go towards the AlCl3. So here positive sign nitrogen will acquire. Okay, I hope that you are getting. So now what would be there, this is LU means anilinium aluminium trichloride, and now nitrogen has acquired the positive charge. So now these electron, ring electron, will move towards this side. So here positive sign will be generated. When this will be moving here, so here positive sign, this will be moving here, so here positive sign. Resonating structure you can prepare, means just see 2, 4, 6 position, what would be there, positive sign is generated. That is why ring become electron deficient, ring become electron deficient. And now Friedel-Crafts reaction is an example of electrophilic substitution reaction. In Friedel-Crafts reaction, as far as acylation is concerned, CH3 electrophile is generated. In case of acylation, CH3CO electrophile is generated. So now they will not get the electron because their electron has already been taken away by the nitrogen. Nitrogen of NH2 group. Okay, that is why aniline does not give. Already I explained this one, same thing you have to write here. Okay, that is why aniline does not undergo Friedel-Crafts reaction. Now I have explained this one, diazonium salt of aromatic amines are more stable than those of aliphatic amines. So when I taught you diazonium salt, that time only I have explained, in aliphatic diazonium salt there won't be a dispersal of positive charge, but in aromatic diazonium salt there would be a dispersal of positive charge acquired by the nitrogen, and all those resonating structure you have to prepare. So what would be there, when positive charge is dispersed, stability will increase. In aliphatic diazonium salt, that facility is not there. There won't be process of dispersal of positive charge. That is why it is unstable. Okay. Last question is, Gabriel thalamide synthesis is preferred for synthesis of primary amines. Just see, here two questions can be prepared. Gabriel thalamide synthesis is preferred for synthesis of primary amines. They have not mentioned aromatic or aliphatic, but you remember in Gabriel thalamide synthesis only aliphatic primary amine can be synthesized. Aliphatic primary amine, aromatic primary amine cannot be synthesized. Reason also I have explained. For the preparation of aromatic primary amines, you have to take chlorobenzene, and chlorobenzene does not undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. I have already explained that one. That is why only aliphatic primary amines can be prepared, but aromatic primary amines cannot be prepared. For the preparation of aliphatic primary amines, instead of chlorobenzene, you have to take chloroethane or chloromethane, and they are aliphatic halogen compound. Okay, they are haloalkanes. What are they? haloalkanes, and haloalkanes very easily undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. Nucleophilic substitution reaction. So that is another question. Here question is Gabriel thalamide synthesis is preferred for the synthesis of primary amines. Just see, there are basically two methods for the synthesis of amines. One is ammonolysis and another one is Gabriel thalamide synthesis. In ammonolysis, what is there? What is the biggest problem in ammonolysis? Disadvantage you have written. In ammonolysis, mixture of 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree amines you are getting. And since their boiling point is very close, their separation is very, very difficult. While in Gabriel thalamide, only one amines, that is 1 degree aliphatic amines is formed. That is why for the synthesis of primary amines, Gabriel thalamide synthesis is preferred over ammonolysis. Actually here, what should be the question? Gabriel thalamide synthesis is preferred over ammonolysis for the synthesis of primary amines. That should be the question. But they have not written here ammonolysis, but the hidden meaning is you have to compare the Gabriel thalamide synthesis with ammonolysis. So answer I wrote, since mixture of amines is not formed, okay, mixture of amines is not formed. If mixture of amines is formed, it means what is there? Their boiling points are close and separation would be difficult, okay, as was the case with ammonolysis. In Gabriel thalamide, only 1 degree primary amines, primary aliphatic amines will be formed. So please remember, aliphatic amines are only, 1 degree aliphatic amines is only formed. In case of Gabriel thalamide synthesis, aromatic primary amines cannot be synthesized. Okay, so just see here. Exercise number 13.4. Arrange the following. And from this particular portion, one question you will have. Which question you will have, even I don't know. So just see, but they are very easy. Arrange the following. In decreasing order of the PKV value, okay? So greater the PKV value, weaker will be the base. So just see, C2H5NH2, C6H5NHCH3, then C2H5 whole twice NH and C6H5NH2, aniline is there. Okay, so which is having the highest PKV value? Which is the weaker base? So decreasing order means decreasing, highest to lowest. Increasing order means lowest to highest. Decreasing means descending of series. Increasing means ascending of series. So the highest PKV value who will have? C6H5NH2, okay? Highest, okay? PKV value, I am not arranging according to the basic strength, PKV value. Which will have the highest PKV value? This one, C6H5NH2. And after this one, which will have? This one. This is unsubstituted aniline. And always remember, unsubstituted aniline are more basic than aniline. So in terms of PKV value, now if PKV value of aniline is highest, then second highest they would be. But in basic strength, they would be more basic than aniline. Remember, okay? And in video, I have explained that one. It is not given in NCERT book. So now next one is C6H5NHCH3. Now which would be the next one? Next one would be C2H5NH2. C2H5NH2. And here last one is C2H5 whole twice NH. Okay. Now this is according to the PKV value. If I am telling in terms of basic strength, so this would be the highest, first, second, means this order would be the reverse. Okay, just see here. In increasing order of basic strength, increasing order means which is the lowest, first, C6H5NH2, okay, greater than this one, this would be there, C6H5NCH3 whole twice, because this is unsubstituted aniline. And in my video I have explained, once again I am telling you, why they are more basic than aniline. Because with their nitrogen plus I casting group, two CH3 groups are bonded, okay? While in aniline, NH2 group is unsubstituted, okay? And after this one, which would be there? Just see. Here, this is 2 degree. This is then CH3 NH2 and at the end C2H5 whole twice NH. Okay. 2 degree is more. 2 degrees. Yes, it is correct. Okay, no problem. Yes. And now, third one, just see. In increasing order of basic strength, aniline, paranitrotoluene. Now, once again, I am telling you the rule. If electron withdrawing group is attached with aniline, so their basic strength would be less than aniline. If plus I casting group, electron donating group is attached with benzene ring, means attached with the aniline. So their basic strength would be more. So paratoluidine means CH3 group is bonded. So increasing order of basic strength, which would be the highest? First would be paratoluidine. Paratoluidine. Then aniline. Aniline. And then aniline. Okay, you can make structure also. Just see, here I am making, this is NH2. Okay, here CH3, this is paratoluidine. Now just see, electron donating group is there, then aniline, this is aniline NH2. Then what is the next one? NH2. Okay, next one is this. Now here NO2 group is there, here NH2 group is there. Okay, so the first this one, then this one, and at the end electron withdrawing group. Okay, so once again I am telling you the rule. If with aniline electron donating group is attached, their basic strength would be more than that of aniline. If electron withdrawing group is attached with aniline, so their basic strength would be less than aniline. So paranitro means electron withdrawing group, paratoluidine means electron donating group. Okay, that is there. Next one is, see here also two questions are there, A and B, in increasing order of basic strength. So here increasing order of basic strength you have to write. Just see, simple one. This is aniline, this one. So just see, this is aryl alkyl amine. Aryl alkyl amines are more basic than N-substituted aniline. N-substituted aniline is more basic than aniline. This would be the order. Okay? Yes. Yes, it is correct. No problem at all. Next one. In decreasing order of basic strength of gas phase. So in gas phase, what is there? Hydration enthalpy, or hydration is not a matter. Okay. Only which is the matter? Plus I effect. Even steric hindrance will not be matter. So in the gas phase, what is the order? 3-2-1. 3-2-1. Okay. So 3 degree is this one, C2H5 whole thrice N. Then 2 degree, C2H5 whole twice N. Then what is there? C2H5NH2. And at the end, NH3. Ammonia is less basic than aliphatic amines. In increasing order of boiling point, you know alcohol is, just see, alcohol ill boiling point is greater than that of amines. Why? Because O is more electronegative than nitrogen. Hence, in alcohol, OH bond is more polar than that of NH bond. Now, what about this one? Now, just see. This is 2 degree amine. This is 1 degree amine. Here, 2 hydrogen, 2 NH2, 2 hydrogen is there for the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Here, only 1 hydrogen is there for intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So, the highest one is ethyl alcohol. Then next one would be next one would be C2H5NH2. and at the end last one is CH3 whole twice NH. Okay, intermolecular hydrogen bonding is the matter. Greater the number of hydrogen bonded with N, greater will be the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay, so in primary amines 2H2 is there, in secondary amine 1, in tertiary amine only no hydrogen atom, that is why tertiary amine does not undergo intermolecular hydrogen bonding. In increasing order of solubility in water, so greater the tendency to form hydrogen bond with the water, greater will be the solubility in water. So just see, now here what would be there, C6H5 and aniline would be the least, C6H5NH2, then least, second one is C2H5 whole twice NH, highest would be primary amine C2H5NH2. Okay, so please just check this one. Okay, this is correct only. Solubility is depends upon hydrogen bonding with the water. So now why this order is there? Here 2H2 is NH2. So 1 degree amines will form more number of hydrogen bond with the water as compared to 2 degree. And here what is there? Aniline hydrophobic aromatic ring is there, that does not form hydrogen bond with the water. It creates hindrance, hydrophobic nature of aromatic ring. Now question number 13.6 is, describe a method for the identification of primary, secondary and tertiary amines. Also write chemical equation for the reaction. Do you know you have to write the reaction of 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree amines with nitrous acid. Okay, with nitrous acid. Or you can take the example of Hinzberg reagent also, and 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree. So anyone you can take and distinguish. Now just see, there are so many reactions and you can very easily distinguish. Hinzberg reagent is there, reaction with nitrous acid is there. Okay, so please write down these reactions, already I have explained. Next question is, write short notes on the following. Carbyl amine reaction, already I have explained, same reaction you have to write. Diazotization, that also I have explained. Ammonolysis, Hoffman bromamide reaction, coupling reaction, acetylation, Gabriel thalamide synthesis. These reactions already I have taught, full notes I have given. So please note down, see the video and complete it. Rest of exercise tomorrow I will complete. Today already 52 minute video is there. Please work hard. So dear cadets, just sum up exercise are left, which I will complete tomorrow, and there how you will convert, that is there. Then give the structure of A, B, C in the following reactions. So remaining all those exercises tomorrow I will complete. Thank you.